nerds. Let's hear it for them. Three jokes and only half of them are funny. I hope you think all of them are funny by the end of the evening, ladies and gentlemen. Anyway, great to have you here. My name is Doug Nunn, and I'm really happy that we're all back. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce my coach, co-coach, Mindy Ballantyne. Let's hear it for Mindy. I'd like to also introduce our keyboard player for the last multiple years. She graduated from Mendocino High School back in 1999. Let's hear it for Mari Clare. And also, I want to check here. Is there anybody here who's never been to an improv show before? Okay. One. Okay. Good. You're a brave young person to be saying that. Good. Well, basically, then most of you know that we will be coming to you all evening for suggestions. We'll be asking, we'll base all of our skits on your suggestions. Everything will be made up. In fact, you probably don't even know. The dancers made that whole thing up. They really did. I'm not tricking you. I'm not. I really am not. Yes. Yeah. So, we're going to be coming to you. So if I were to ask you, say, on this part of the, what is a part of the world you would really like to visit?
Croatia,
I heard. Okay. North Macedonia. Okay, that's kind of close to Croatia. There you go.
Atlantis.
Okay, good. Well, there you go. Somebody who wants to... I think of that Donovan song every time I think of Atlantis. That's good. Way down below the ocean. Okay, good. How about over here? A dessert you'd really like to have after this show tonight?
Chocolate
mousse. Chocolate mousse, I heard. Anybody else?
Oreos.
Okay, what else?
Brownies.
Okay, good. Well, we got a good team there. So, you have got the idea, ladies and gentlemen. So let's bring out our first two players tonight. We're going to play a game called Freeze Tag first. This is an old-fashioned improv game that's been around forever and a day. What we're going to do is Ash and Sarah are going to start a scene, and then at a certain point, one of the other players will yell, freeze. They'll freeze in position. The new player will come in, tag them out, start a brand new scene from that position, and so on. It'll continue to go on at that point. A variety of short freeze scenes. So, what we would like is a physical position for Ash, please.
Surfing,
okay, good. Surfing, and a physical position for Sarah Rose.
Climbing,
I heard, climbing. So surfing and climbing, let's see where we go. Take it away.
I don't know how you expect to get over those waves on a surfboard.
Dude, you just gotta get on the wave, man.
No, you just gotta climb over it. Come on, be reasonable.
Great.
So, like, dude, what do you think about, like, my bear impression? It's like, you know, I got, like, you know, up in the air, you know, like, you know, we're going hiking next week, so I'm feeling like,
I think, you know. If you're gonna do a good bear impression, you're gonna have to grow longer claws.
You're right. So, okay, so, like, grow bigger claws, but I mean, like, you know, I'm trying to just, like, you know, I'm just trying to, like...
Dude, your body language is way too feminine right now to be a bear. You gotta take up some room.
Okay, well, show me how it's done then.
Like this.
Hey, dude, do I stink?
Oh my god, dude.
I didn't have to be that mean about it.
Have you heard of soap? Or maybe deodorant?
What?
I'm sorry, have you been living under a rock?
I've been living in Mendocino.
Listen, okay? There's some life choices that you need to make, and you
Freeze.
Have made.
Oh my god, I'm having a heart attack! Oh my god, oh my god!
Help me!
Fuck.
Help me!
911!
Freeze!
Faster! Oh, my back! Oh, help me! Freeze. Oh!
Do you
Freeze!
Need-
Okay, Janine, it's time to push!
Right in the ankle. Dude, I don't know if you're gonna make it, okay?
I think I gotta go to the hospital, bro.
Yeah, like that?
Oh, dude, when a scooter swings around and hits you in the ankle.
I saw it all
happen. Oh,
dude! Like, I saw it all happen in, like, slow motion.
Freeze!
Oh, wow, this chair is so comfortable. How much is it?
About $200. So you know, you also got the massage option on it. You know, it's
wow, that's
crazy. Cool.
Hey, yo, Jonesy, give me those spins with me.
Okay.
Those spins. Yeah.
Oh, you know I love spinning.
You're gonna be great at this wedding, man.
You know, I'm gonna go up, there's the flower
water boys go, and then me. Then me with the a little bit of...
Freeze!
Hey, Buster, you gotta get low.
I can see you when you wave above the grass.
Think so? You think they got sharp eyes?
You're my favorite person to play Snake with. You know, you're really good.
I didn't know I was playing Snake. I don't have limbs.
What?
Freeze.
I think I'm stuck.
Dude, you're ruining my yellow shirt.
No, freeze! Okay, come on, stretch it out! Stretch it out! Yeah! Really open up your hip flexor!
Okay.
This is why you hired me to be a personal trainer.
Freeze.
Don't stop.
Janine, I really need you to be honest with me. So, are the polka dots too much for the funeral?
I think Grandma Jess
Freeze.
Really wanted the one.
Freeze.
So how's the dress?
It's a little tight.
No, my dress.
Oh, I see how it is, Gerald.
Guess what? It's your birthday tomorrow. Bet you didn't know that. Because you don't know. It's okay. There's a lot of things I don't know either.
No, it's your birthday tomorrow. I know! It is!
Hey.
Do you hear the voices?
I've heard it. It's scary.
I've seen people.
It sounds like a rat if it got caught.
Freeze!
Okay, so welcome to your first day of working at Jurassic Park. Okay, rule number
okay.
one.
Do I get to
Freeze.
Roll in the little balls?
I am gonna need to see your manager right now!
I don't have a manager, actually.
Okay, well then
I'm
you can fix this problem.
And you know where the hospital is. I have to be stabbed at 3:30 sharp.
Who you got stabbing you?
Well, I'm looking for a position.
How are you my dad anyway? It doesn't really add up.
You see, it worked like this. There was a crystal ball. And it was at the peak of a mountain. And
Freeze.
I...
They did it again.
Again?
Yeah. They tried to make me wear pants to church today, and I didn't want to at first.
I wear pants every time, and they never kick me out. I'm a big boy. They even let me go up
Freeze.
There.
Listen, I don't care who the IRS sends, I'm not paying my taxes.
Dude, you're above this. I just
Freeze.
Never look the cow into its eyes, okay? whatever you do, don't get straight in the eyes.
Freeze, man.
Man, what'd you put in this stuff?
I don't know how to smoke, man. I was hoping you knew.
Freeze. Go, Billy! Kick the soccer ball! You got it, baby!
Okay, for our next bit, we need Max out here. Max is going to be a moderator in a very intense debate. So can I get the debaters up, please? And can I get from the audience a toy to discuss, that somebody could have some strong feelings about.
Legos.
Okay, so Max will be conducting this debate about Legos. So let's bring lights down and bring them back up.
Welcome back to the afternoon hour. Today, it's all about toys. And not just any kind of toys. We're talking about the classics. We're talking about Legos. So, Mr. Edward, when did you first see a Lego?
Well, when I was a little boy, girl, I was very fond of Legos.
Well, that's really great. The first time I saw a Lego, I rubbed my finger on it real hard, and it felt amazing. I think you should give it a try. Anyway, Jamie, you're very young, and I know you've only been here since the 2021 launch. And how did that make you feel?
It was an exciting and terrifying and horrifying experience.
No. I mean, the dinosaur ones weren't that scary, unless you were literally a baby, but, you know, you were. Anyway, how have they shaped your childhood?
They really, 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 really make me feel good.
That's what we're trying to do. That's what we're trying to do here at Lego. Anyway, I happened to bring a couple bricks, and I wanted to let you feel the difference. And if you can guess which brick is which, I'll even give you one. Eyes closed. Take the brick. What do you think it is?
A Lego. Anyway.
That was a lot of words. Didn't quite catch it.
A. Yes.
Got it. And we got the new yes brick. Excellent job. So, do you think you have a future in Legos?
I really do.
You really do? Well, it turns out you do not, because Lego is going to be discontinued next year. How does that make you feel?
It makes me feel really ecstatic.
That is absolutely messed up here. Lego do not appreciate such emotions. So, what sorrowful emotions does Lego make you feel?
When I was just turning 12, my grandfather touched me.
Awesome. Have you ever stepped on a Lego brick?
I once had a mother.
Awesome. You know, I'm going to tell you a story, and I'm going to measure your response with the new Lego thermometer. Rectal Lego thermometer. Okay, so, one day a man, he took about 5K Lego bricks, and he built himself a car. But this car wasn't very fast, you see, because it had no wheels. How does that make you feel?
It makes me really hard.
That is... Well, we got that same car right here. Anyway. When did you first fall in love?
I was 5 years old.
Do you think you would have been able to fall in love if there weren't Legos?
No.
There we go, right there. All right, this is the last question. All right, it's been an hour. Listen close, because this one's gonna be a little tricky to understand. What's your favorite Lego brick?
The old fashioned brick.
The yellow one or the red one? Come on.
Brick. Blue.
Blue. This guy is a classic fan. All right. Last question. So, I know you're only 4 years old, but when was the Lego company founded?
When?
And what were you doing at that moment?
Gwen saw your Legos,
I
was
All right, everybody, give it up for our Lego connoisseurs.
Gentlemen, we'd like for our next one, we'd like a name of a monster that has yet to be. What is the name of a monster that you've never heard of?
Jeremy.
What's that?
Jeremy.
Jeremy the monster. Okay. Now, Jeremy is a monster, and we're going to get all the players up. And what they're going to do is they're going to give you Jeremy's story. They're all going to play Jeremy. They're going to tag each other in and out, and they will be showing you what Jeremy is really like. Jeremy, the horrible monster. Let's bring the lights down, and when they come back up, you will hear Jeremy's story.
Oh, I am not a scary monster. Truly, I am just really, really big, and people are kind of racist about that. I got horns, and I got a pretty little tail, and I want you to know how I grew up. I hatched from an egg laid by a giant. And that's my dad. And every now and again, my dad goes stomping around, knocking over buildings. And I say, Dad, but there are people too. And he just keeps stomping and stomping. And how am I supposed to make friends if they're all dead?
But when I ask my dad why he's stomping on all the buildings, all he says is, don't you want to eat dinner? And I said, well, I guess so, but
I hatched the plan. I was gonna save the little people, but first I needed money. How was I gonna get the money?
I was going to rob the nearest McDonald's. And so I went to the nearest McDonald's and I got $3 whole. And from that,
Now that I'm rich, I'm able to fund my counterattack scheme involving a catapult and a lot of banana bombs. That's like when you take a banana and you compress it into a ball of monster energy, and it flies at my dad, and I think,
man, I'm really saving the whole world right now. And that's pretty cool. When I grow up, I want to save twice as many worlds. And maybe I'll get twice as much money to do it too.
But I was drawing up my schemes and I was collecting the bananas, and my dad, he saw my scheme and he came over to me and he went up and he said,
son, are you planning to overthrow me?
And I
said, yeah, Dad! Your tyrannical rule is too much! It's my time to rule! It's my time to make friends! And
I'm gonna get all my little friends, and they're gonna get on my back, and we're gonna be 10 times taller than you ever were, Dad! You're never gonna tell me what to do again.
I love you, Dad, but your rule is now. It is my time to shine. It is my time to rule.
And curtain.
Okay, so how many of you have watched soap operas? Yes. And you understand the drama that can happen in a soap opera. So many amazing things. So this next scene is going to be a soap opera scene. And what is something, what could be a problem at a hospital?
Can't find the patient.
Okay, so let's get the players out for soap opera. And we'll bring the lights down when we bring them back up. This is a scene in a hospital, soap opera style.
Excuse me. My dad's not in his room. Like, he was supposed to be there in his bed, but he's not. Did you guys move him? Like, what's the deal?
Well, dude, if you want to find your dad, you're gonna have to go through me first.
Oh my god, Dr. Randall! I found the missing patient! Come with me, quickly! You stay here.
What? But he's my father!
Didn't find the patient. I think we should sneak away. I think we should too, man. This dude keeps asking me about his lost dad.
Hey!
It's really distracting me from this romantic thought.
What does he look like? What does he look like? Oh shit, that's my boyfriend.
Gee, I thought I was your boyfriend.
Wait.
You're my work boyfriend.
You're...
Let's focus on your dad! Oh my god, babe, I can't believe he's missing! Let's go find him!
Dad! Dad!
Dad!
Where could he go?
No.
Dad!
We better check the cafeteria. Your dad really is into those pudding cups.
Yeah! You should go! Go check the cafeteria!
You're
I'll be right
me.
Behind you!
All the puddings are gone!
God.
I
loved
him anyways. I just want you.
We can just...
Glad we got away from that guy.
I'm right here.
Okay, let's find an empty patient room. One of those beds that goes up and down.
Well, I mean, his dad's not in his room, so...
You're so smart. This is why I love you, babe. Let's go.
Where you guys go? You gotta be find my dad.
Yeah,
I'll be right back, babe. I love you so much. I'm totally gonna help you find him.
I'm just gonna check his room really quick.
Yeah, we're gonna look under the bed. He's very nimble.
You're right.
Go check the pudding cups
again. At 93, he is pretty nimble for his age.
You deal with the pudding. We'll find your dad. Come on.
And curse. So, Joaquin, you're in this one too, okay? Replacing Zen. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna play a game called Dutch Square, and what we'd like is the four players to come up, and they're gonna take a square. Joaquin, go ahead and be better. You go, right there, perfect. So, what we're gonna do is get an emotion for each player, and we'll say, we need an emotion for Alden scenes to start with.
Ennui.
Okay, so boredom. Boredom. But don't let that be stick you with that, okay? Clark. Good. And a different one, completely different for Vale.
Angry.
I heard angry first. You were angry. We'll start with that. Clark. A different one for Joaquin.
Joyous,
I heard. Joyous. Clark. And finally one for Andre.
Devious.
Did you happen to notice his face when you did? I'm just here. All right, good. Now what's going to happen is let's have each player mention that. I'm going to say Clark first. First of all, Andre, say yours.
Devious.
Clark.
Four.
Clark.
Thank you.
Clark.
Joyous.
We're going to start a scene with Joaquin and Vale. It's going to be a joyous scene to start with. The players are not stuck with their emotions. They can move from there. At a certain point, I will say clock. They'll move in that direction. We'll go back to Andre's scene, etc., moving around. When I say counter, they have to move in the opposite direction. All right? We'll start with Joaquin and Vale doing a joyous scene. Let's bring the lights down.
The sun, it shines so brightly, brighter than ever before.
Wow. I'm just so joyous at this occasion and event.
Aren't you? Don't worry, it doesn't, the sun, it may be expanding,
yeah.
And it's going to consume the earth, but that's a good thing. We'll all be so warm in the glorious rays of our God.
Yay. Wait, but it disappears at night.
Clock.
Ooh, Joaquin.
Very nice thing.
It sure is.
Those pants of yours, they're tattered.
Oh, thank you. Oh, you are this. Oh.
And that goes your.
Oh, no!
And only me.
Probably just gonna like sit in a corner and.
No. We can sit in a corner together.
Clock.
I found him. The one who's been putting those rocks in my shoes. I put them in my locker for PE and somebody's been sneaking in and stuffing rocks in them. It's not fair.
I'm sorry. I don't know what to tell you.
It's your own fairy brother. I need you to go beat him up for me.
Oh, no, I can't do that. He's such a sweetheart.
Friends support each other. Don't worry that the sun goes away at night. We can build our own sun, an idol of our very beautiful god.
Who?
Iolus, the sun god.
Oh, of course. Yes.
Are you not aware of our great god of holiness and beauty? Say his name to me. So I can be sure you are aware.
Sun God.
No!
I know exactly what to do with the pack thread.
I collected all the keys of the new high school.
No!
Every single door.
No!
And I'm going to connect them all.
No!
And have a magical key ring.
No!
And they'll do nothing about it! Not Coleman! One more time!
You can't leave me. It's gonna be so boring without you.
I don't even like parties.
Yes, you do. You're the one who showed me how cool parties are.
What? All I do is dance! I just look at other people being happy and I dance!
Counter.
Please, I just want my key thread back.
I will now collect the final key.
Oh, no.
The key to your heart. Because, Rocky,
I love you.
Mendocino, you are very lucky tonight because Catan is going to be interviewing a foreign dictator who has come to Mendocino County and has a lot to say. Unfortunately, he doesn't speak English, so he's going to have interpreters to help you understand him. We're going to have Hun, who is going to...
He's actually Pappy.
Oh, Pappy, sorry. Pappy, come on up. Pappy is going to be doing body interpretation, sort of like a sign language. And then... Catan here is going to be interpreting what he says. But now, Jack came to Mendocino County, and he's upset about something. What is he upset about here in Mendocino?
The rain.
The rain. Rain too, yes. Yeah. They're all the rain. Okay, let's take the lights down and come back up.
His Majesty, Josque the Eighth, has graced us with an appearance in our humble village. However, he has some complaints. He has prepared a speech for your enjoyment. Blocking.
What? That's the prince that's God bless us to flame in that completely.
My dog melts in the rain. I brought him out for a walk in your redwoods. But as the rain began to touch his fur, he began to dissolve into the soil. I cried over that patch of ground and cursed the land from which it came, Mendocino. I now have that sample of dirt in a jar to remember my dog.
Lemminstein and Dumentreinen in the brain, and Duven and dog's dead.
I've had that sweet, sweet companion as a child growing up in the royal palace. It grew with me and I grew with it, and now the dog is dead.
Boris, Boris, keep up in the name. It's your name on Bolt, Bolt.
Boris, Boris, my sweet, sweet dog. How could you leave me so? I think I will have to burn Mendocino down.
Did that in Dutch, pow! In it on the high school, pow! Did on the Harvest Market, pow!
Your critical infrastructure shall fall no matter how wet it is. One after the other, your high school, your grocery store, it shall erupt into flames.
In my little flada, in a stone, stone, pumping a little Mendocino in the Boris.
I shall stomp upon the remains of Mendocino as I stomped upon the remains of my enemies in wars past with my dog Boris as my companion.
And I, in the steaming and steaming, and up, 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 chicka, boop,
count your days, Mendocinians.
Okay. Now I need something that you're going to bring up with your mom about. Something of a teenager. Marriage? Okay, let's see marriage. So let's get the players up. So I need a number for Sarah between 1 and 6. Wrong. Try again. 4. I heard 4. Okay, Sarah's got 4. A number between 1 and 6 that's not 4.
2.
2. 2 for Max. And a number between 1 and 6 that is not 2 or 4.
1.
1. 1 for Alden. So that is how many words they can use when they talk. Okay, so we're going to hear a scene about a teenager talking to his parents about marriage. Okay, bring the lights down and bring it back up.
Parents!
Hi, son. How are you?
No wife.
Stress.
Because you have no?
Wife you?
Lonely.
I am as well.
What? Mean?
Father.
What is your problem?
No.
Yes, please tell me.
Marriage.
No problem.
No problem at all.
Marriage? Good.
You should do it.
Okay.
Who will you wed?
Who wife?
Me.
You marry yourself, yes?
Yeah.
Bad idea.
Wonderful idea. Will happy.
Question.
Yes, what is it?
Marriage.
Yes, of course.
Marriage, marriage.
Good?
Yes, very, very good.
Very good.
Really?
You should do it! Marry yourself right now.
Happy wife.
I am ordained minister. Do you take you?
Do you? That's a good one. I'll remember that one. All right, folks. How about a big event in a school year? What might that be?
Prom.
Okay, prom. Well, we'll take prom. Let's bring the players up. All righty. Ladies and gentlemen, there are often many perspectives that happen about a big event like a prom. We're now going to get a variety of perspectives on the prom. So let's get a little bit closer up, please. Okay.
I'm always the lead hotshot when it comes to prom. I come to the parking lot, chew my gum, and all the hotties come to see me. I'll take off my shirt, you know what I got. I never had a date.
Oh, I'm so excited to see all of these students coupling up together. I love to see little Josie and Bobby together, and Bruno and Jamaya. They are my favorite little sweeties of the high school at Mendocino.
Now, being the cool teacher I am, I thought I'd do a good favor to the students by spiking the fruit punch with some special teacher sauce. Really give the kids a good time at this dance. They deserve that.
So, I went to prom, and I had some of that punch, and then I got really loopy. And I had the best prom of my life.
I freaking hate Bruno. He's always showing up to my prom and ruining my prom jazz with his gum and going, big hot shot. He made my wife leave me. That's not fair.
This year, I won't be able to go to prom. Because I'm too busy doing all these assignments that the teachers keep on assigning us. And you know what? I'm fed up. I see what they do with their free time, and it's not helping me. Nah, I see what they do to the punch.
I'm not actually a student at Mendo High, but, you know, luckily no one's figured that out yet. I usually just wander around the halls, I listen to gossip, but when prom comes up, I can't not sneak in.
I'm real tired of not having anybody go to prom with. I don't know if it's because this gum is giving me man titties, but I figure I'm gonna put some good use to it. I'm gonna spit it in one of those loveless Cretans' faces this year. They're gonna get it! They're gonna get it real this time!
So, we all went to prom, and it was pretty packed, and a lot of other people had that punch. My favorite song came on. It was called Don't Hold Back. And when it came on, I went, ah!
Okay, so I got a plan, right? You know the punch? The spiked punch? Yeah, I know something real good. I'm gonna poison it, and I'm gonna give it to Bruno, and then his little chewing, and that's giving him man titties. And it's gonna be gone.
Looking forward to the prom this year, but then at the prom, students started screaming. Some of them started passing out on the floor from poison. And I started to regret becoming a teacher.
Now, in hindsight, it might have been a bad idea spiking the punch. A lot of the students started dying, which I wasn't really quite attempting. Some of the others are still awake, they start getting rowdy, and those who are remaining at the dance, well, it turned to more of a mosh pit. Everyone's beating each other up, and I got a black eye, but
It was still pretty fun.
So I'm going around the building. I'm looking for open windows. I don't find one, but that's okay. It's why I brought the brick. So I have a pretty strong throwing arm. And after that, I have free access to go in with my grappling hook, and I'm already going up there. And it is chaos in there. I mean, oh, wow, I'm glad I came.
Okay, so our next scene is called Puppets. And if you know anything about puppets, you know that puppets cannot move on their own. They have to have somebody move them. And that's what this scene is about. So let's get the puppets and the puppeteers out here. And what is a tough physical job to accomplish?
Mining.
Mining would be a tough physical job to accomplish. So Ash is going to be the puppet and Lillian the puppeteer. And Catan will be the puppet with Noah as the puppeteer. And they cannot move at all unless their puppeteer moves them. So let's bring the lights down and bring it back up and see puppets learn how to mime.
Wow, this is a tough rock. Don't you think so, Jimmy?
Yeah. Man.
Yeah, I'm trying to crack it in my hands and it just ain't doing it. You know,
When I played Minecraft, this seemed a lot easier.
Yeah, you know me too. That's the only reason I signed up, really. You know, you watch it on YouTube and it looks so easy.
I was really hoping to find some diamonds today.
You know, I heard Brimby went over and he found some crystals. Yeah, don't you think that's cool? Don't you think that's cool?
I'm very impressed.
Yeah, you know, Brimby, he's always getting so much money from these crystals. It's like he can smell the ore through the rock.
I'm so impressed I could just fly.
Yeah, sometimes I like to think I'm a bird. I think it's just because I'm down underground so long. I just think about the air so frequently.
You know, boy, so do I.
Maybe that's the difference between us and Brimby. I think Brimby's got his mind on the rocks, you know?
You know what they say about Brimby behind his back?
I don't, you know, I'm always at Brimby's front.
Well, behind his back,
oh my,
they say he's got some coal on his butt.
Oh my gosh! You know, I wouldn't doubt it. That man is one with the stone. He's a tough guy.
If I had coal on my butt, I would want someone to tell me.
Do you think we should?
I think we should after we find the diamonds.
Okay. So, all right. I'm thinking like a bird again. I'm never gonna find
you know what? I'm feeling good.
You're feeling good?
Yeah.
You think we're about to find the crystal?
I think we're about to find it right
All
now.
All right, here, let's see. I'm gonna hit the rock. Oh, wow. Oh, would you look at that? I'm seeing something in there.
Oh!
I'm seeing something.
Oh, it's coal. Hopefully I don't get any on my butt.
Yeah, or black lung. You know, maybe Brimby got black lung. You think of that? I hear him coughing a lot.
It must have spread to his butt.
Oh no!
All righty. Ladies and gentlemen, before we do our last bit of the first half and you go to a 15-minute intermission, I would like to introduce the people who have been seniors who have played with us since they first came. And I think that was in the COVID year, wasn't it? Yes, it was. And Jack and Sarah, let's have Jack and Sarah and Ash and Pappy all stand up. Let's hear it. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, where is a odd place to take a vacation? Where might be an odd place?
Ohio.
Ohio, I heard. Okay, good. An odd place. Oh my goodness. All right, okay, good. Okay, this is about Catans. We're gonna see a wonderful slideshow to end the first act of our show. And this will be Catan's vacation in Ohio. So let's bring Catan over here. And we are going to see some wonderful slides from his trip to Ohio. So let's bring the lights back down and let's have the slide people get ready.
Hello, everybody. Thank you for coming. It's so great to see you here tonight. Now, listen, I got on this wonderful plane to a wonderful vacation over in Ohio. It was a great time. I got to see some family that lived there. I don't know why. But I thought, you know, I'd get some pictures to show you tonight. I have a slideshow here for you. So without further ado, first slide, please. Okay, so you can see here the plane has landed. There's actually some guy who almost stumbled in front of it, like he almost got planed. So people are holding him back. It was almost quite the freak accident, you know that? But luckily, no one got hurt, and we arrived safely in Ohio. So next slide, please. Now something you'll notice about in Ohio is that they're always locking hands with each other. Always grabbing. I feel like it's just part of the Ohio wind culture. But that's one of the mannerisms I got used to. So here I'm being paraded through the streets. They tend to do this sort of ritual to newcomers to the state. It was a grand old time. They showed me all their bookstores. I love books. Next slide, please. I'm praying to God for forgiveness here because I accidentally dropped a book on someone's head and he got very injured. Now, this haunts me to this day. I still don't know if he ended up all right, but I almost got put in jail. I almost got put in jail, but I ended up framing this other guy, so an officer can't take him. So I got off scot-free. Next slide, please. So, I don't know if you guys heard about it on the news, but there was a good period of time where they thought Ohio was going to be consumed in a giant fireball from above by this gigantic meteor. It didn't end up happening. It diverted at the last minute, which is painful, but you can see here, I've resigned to my fate. At the time, I believed this was my punishment for killing a man. But people are going wild in the streets. They're going feral. It was a dark time, and I won't ever forget it. Next slide, please. So me and my friends, my new Ohio buddies, we still keep in touch, are all celebrating here because we weren't all consumed in a giant fireball. And by now, I'm getting pretty tired. I've had a bit too much Ohio for me to handle. And so luckily there's a kind man that is standing kind of between me, but also over me. Which is, it's kind of the Ohio way to say, hey, take it easy. So now I'm wrapping up this trip. I'm about to go back. But there's this one magnificent photo I have to show you of my return trip. Me leaving Ohio. Oh yeah, look at that. I'm here, this is where the planes train. And this is one of the planes' first day on the job, and I'm really giving it an encouraging word. It was super happy. to be leaving the flock and finally becoming a plane for people to fly on. And so, you know, it's a marvelous day. The mom is taking pictures, and I later go on that plane to return here. And here I am, and I'm so happy to be back, but it was such a great trip, and I think I might go back next year.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be back after a 15-minute intermission. Let's hear it for the players. called New Choice here coming out. So what is a good way to impress a new teacher? What's that?
Give them an apple.
Give them an apple. We'll start with an apple and we'll see what happens. All right, folks, we're going to have Jack and Alden and, NB?
This guy.
Oh, yes, of course. Nadia Bugutsky, yes. We're going to have them, and they're going to do a scene about impressing a new teacher. Now, at any point, if one of the players says something that I think they need to change, so I'm going to hop the horn, and they have to say something different, okay? This is called New Choice. I'll be yelling New Choice and honking the horn. How to impress a new teacher? Let's bring the lights down.
All right, class. So for today's assignment, you have to impress me.
Oh, really? I have to impress you.
You do, or you'll get an F.
Oh, really now?
Really
now? Oh, really now?
Oh, really?
Okay.
I have an apple for you. I don't know.
It's rotten.
Nice one.
Hey, big shot. Check this out. I've been learning this one.
Nice job.
New physical choice. New physical choice.
Ah.
Pretty impressed,
look,
right?
Call me impressed, Jeremy. It's a good one. Now, what do you think? What do you have to do?
Huh?
Impress me. Jeremy
gave you an apple.
A rotten apple?
That's what I'm supposed to do.
You're trying to impress me with a rotten apple?
It was not rotten.
Okay, wait. How about this one?
See, why could you be more like Jeremy?
Come on. New physical choice. New physical choice.
If you were more like my prize student, Jeremy, you'd actually be, not failing this class?
I can't physically do that, man.
No choice.
I can do that so well, it's impossible, man.
No choice.
Arms are ridiculous. How does he do that?
You know, I'm wondering the same thing.
How can I ever be of such importance as Jeremy?
You can't.
It takes a lot of yoga, you know. My yoga instructor, Derek, he's a wonderful man. He teaches me the ways of how to impress people.
I'm going to impress you guys so much with that one. This one. You ready? You
ready.
Watching me? You ready?
Holy! Now, why can't people like her, Jeremy?
Jack,
no, Jeremy, I think I love her.
Whoa. Teach.
Shocking. It's over between us, Jeremy. You're no longer my prize student.
No choice.
No.
You're now my second prize student.
No choice.
How can I bring my grade up? Come on.
Sure. Give teach a twirl.
No choice.
Pop a swat.
No choice.
I want you to get funky like Funky Town. Funky
Town. Okay, right. Come on, Derek.
Oh, yeah.
I'm ashamed of myself.
You truly won back my favor, Jeremy. You truly are my prize student. I'm thoroughly impressed.
Good choice.
I'm thoroughly somewhat impressed with your performance.
Good choice.
Your performance did not impress me, but it's a passing grade.
Oh, that means a lot. I'm so glad I've come this far.
Little do you know that I've also been in Derek's yoga session.
What?
Yeah.
My God.
I know. You ready?
I know. Yeah.
And how this works is that each player is going to get a genre. Let's go ahead and do that first. Can I get a film genre for Pappy?
Horror.
And for Vale?
Sci-fi.
And for Catan?
Romance.
And for Alden?
Sasquatch documentary.
And for Noah?
Psychological horror.
Yes, that's great. And then for Andre?
Punk rock.
Okay, and then
Western.
One for Ash. A Western for Ash. Okay, so how this is going to work is that the person who's sitting in the driver's seat is going to state their genre, and they're going to have a scene with the person beside them and the person in the back. And then they're going to find a reason to leave the scene, and when they get out, they're going to rotate through. The person that's over here is going to move into the driver's seat, and they're going to start their genre. And to remind you, when they get into the driver's seat, they'll say their genre again. And so for right now, let's just go ahead and say the genres one more time.
Horror.
Sci-fi.
Romance. Sasquatch documentary.
Psychological horror.
Punk rock!
Western.
Okay, so let's have the first three up in their seats. And then take the lights down and bring it back up.
Oh, he's having another one of his episodes. Brian, take your meds. Here's your belt. Take a pill, Brian.
Such a lovely day today.
What did you just give him?
Oh, his meds.
No, I gave him his meds. You gave him something from your pocket.
Did you want some?
He just coughed out
Guys. A
crystal. That can't be good.
Oh, that's what he does. He's our business. We sell the crystals he barfs and we make tons of money.
What? I never knew about this.
Eat the crystal.
Look.
You'll like it.
Oh, yeah, that's kind of umami. Like, that's like soy sauce. Like, that's a good flavor.
Yeah!
That's a fresh palate. Now, we gotta start marketing this stuff. You got an Instagram account set up? I can do Canva. I can make some
Instagram,
ads.
Instagram, the most horrible platform of all.
Everyone will love the crystal.
Okay.
Yes.
It's time for me to go to my lair.
Goodbye.
Sci-fi.
My people on board the alien space station are trapped.
And what people are those? Are your people conquerors, or are they a peaceful sort?
The Schnibbed Galabians are a mixed sort. Half of them are red and are aggressive, and the other half are blue and love everybody.
Okay, and are the ones on the space station red or blue?
Well, I hate to say it, but they tend towards purple colors. They're unpredictable.
Oh, hey there.
Hey.
Who are you?
Well,
I've been here the whole time.
This is our friendly blue Schlobding Nagin.
How can you tell if they're red or blue? I mean, your face is very green and yours is white.
It's a blue that your eyes can't see.
That really unnerves me. Let's not go to the space station. We're gonna head to Omega Prime and we're going to get,
Turn the steering wheel a little bit to the right. That galaxy right there.
Going into this nebula.
My people are trapped. You're going to leave them to die?
Yes, definitely.
It's all.
Hey, buddy, what's a few more? You know, it's okay.
You're right, Reginald.
All
right,
we're heading into an asteroid field. We need to hit as many of these as possible.
Yes.
Because they will heal our ship.
Of course.
All right, brace for impact.
Bam!
Bam! Bam! Okay, we're out.
Wonderful.
Didn't that feel good? Very, very exhilarating.
It's like a massage.
Yes, no, it is. That's why we try to hit the asteroids. All right.
Oh, my gosh.
Steer for another
time. I'm picking up a ship on the long-range scanners.
What kind of ship?
the bad kind.
Oh no! I don't want to die! Emergency transport!
Romance.
So, how's it going?
I've been better without you. I have been worse.
Spicy, I see.
You know it.
Dude, nice butt, bro.
Thanks, bro.
I concur.
You know, I really like the way you grip that steering wheel.
Do you?
Yeah.
I've been practicing.
You know, maybe sometime you should grip my steering wheel.
Whoa. Oh, I don't think I can focus on driving.
Come on, Papa Bear, it'll be all right. Just look at the road.
I'm looking.
Just look at the road.
Hey, your arms' hairs make me lustful, bro.
Okay, just look at the
I'm
road.
I'm looking. Oh, you almost honked the horn.
Maybe I was trying to.
Hey, stop focusing on the road and focus on
Hey, no. Me. Road doesn't matter. All that matters is me and you. Right now. Not even him.
Hey.
I almost missed the exit. Okay. I think we'd better stop and...
No!
Come on, there's a gazebo nearby. It's great. You love it. Please, let me show you.
Have you ever watched Twilight?
Can we watch it together at the gazebo?
Oh my gosh, that would be wonderful. Sasquatch documentary.
Sasquatches are pretty interesting, bro.
Oh yes, Sasquatches are quite mysterious creatures. You know, ancient alien theorists theorize that Sasquatches, the reason we can't capture them on camera is because they teleport.
Holy crap, there's a Sasquatch! Oh my god!
I can't believe I'm seeing it with my own eyes!
Oh hey, bro. How's it going, bro?
Can you believe this, folks? A real Sasquatch! Right here! Right now!
Hey. Do you like dog kibble?
Oh god. I can't do this.
You're on your own.
Psychological horror.
Where you taking us?
Who knows? The question is not where am I taking you, but where God's taking us all.
So you want to play God?
Not really.
Is this guy all good?
Yeah, no, he's fine. He's just putting on his shoes, bro.
What's up with him? He's breathing real heavy.
Can you tie your shoes? Tie my shoes fine. Take the wheel. You know, you should really be old enough to do this on your own.
Hey, bro, you need an inhaler or something?
Oh, dude, can I hit that inhaler, bro? Okay, that's good. Dude, what are you looking at, bro?
Exit! 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 Exit!
Alright, alright.
Punk rock.
I think we should have brought our instruments.
Dude, we don't need instruments, we are instruments!
This is my solo. Alright, your turn.
I got one for you.
Rock on, brother!
That's how you do it!
Yeah!
Rock on!
Rock on!
You guys suck.
Wester.
You two ever heard of the Law Out? They're like outlaws, but different.
You know,
they say they roam these parts.
I've been called a law out before.
Oh, I really don't think so. They don't call people that lightly. It's a loaded term.
Hey, our horse has a couple of spikes in its heel. Maybe we should,
Oh, that's just Bessie. We give Bessie those. It helps her with her mental illness.
But she's limping.
Oh, yeah, that's
sure that's how she likes it. Just feed her an apple.
Don't question Bessie.
There you go, Bessie.
Okay. I don't mind a quirky horse.
Bessie's a strong, independent horse who can make her own choices.
You can't push Bessie around. If you're gonna be a real cowboy, you gotta let the horse take you through the Wild West to where it wants to go.
Exactly. It is its own being, and you should let it control you.
And where are we going again?
The Wild West.
We're going to Steven's Tavern? Yeah, I heard they have good ale at Steven's Tavern.
I think it's Joe's Tavern. I think you got it all off.
Oh, you're right.
Yeah, all right.
Yeah, Joe's such a good
partner. Good man. You're gonna be real cowboys. You're gonna need some thicker chaps than those. They won't accept anything less than the best chaps at Joe's Tavern. They won't let you in there.
Oh, so how am I gonna do that?
We're
gonna have to skin Bessie.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna do.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna bring Ash back and Pun out. Let's bring Pun out. What might be a possible rivalry between two students?
Great.
What's that?
Spelling bee.
Spelling bee. Oh, great. Spelling bee. Great. These are two spelling bee champions, ladies and gentlemen, and we're going to hear two sides of a story about a spelling bee. Let's bring the lights back down, please. And bring them up.
Dude, my mom made me do the spelling bee because, like, she said I was getting a little bit rusty with my knowledge, and she said I had to, like, practice or whatever. So I tried to practice learning some words with my buddy, Valencia, but I just kept getting all the words wrong, bro. And it really was affecting my confidence.
There's a bomb strapped to my chest. If I don't win this, I'm gone, and I'm taking everyone with me.
There's this kid at my school. He says he's the smartest kid, and if he doesn't win the spelling bee, he's gonna blow everyone up. But I think if he's really so smart, he would win without violence, dude, and just chill. God.
It's not a violent threat. A threat implies that nothing is gonna happen. They're called empty threats for a reason. You know, no, no, no. What I'm gonna do is a promise.
So, I practiced my words, dude. And I get up there for the spelling bee. And I get up to the mic. And I got one right. And my confidence skyrocketed, dude. But I was scared for my life.
If this kid, Jimmy, thinks he's gonna win by getting one word right, well, he's got a couple of things in store for him. Because I've been practicing since the day I got born. Since the day I slid out, I've been saying A, B, C. I've been going at it. I am ready for this. So, the first word comes up. Ascot.
So that weird kid that was threatening everybody gets up. His word's ascot. Kind of like mascot, but like different, you know? It's like for your ass. I mean, I actually didn't practice that one, which really was shooting my confidence back down. But then, he spelt it with an M in the front. I'm like, dude! And then my confidence skyrocketed back up.
So I see Jimmy in the crowd. He's so happy. And that's great for him. That's great. It's not good for me. So you know what I did? I am a honest man. I keep my promises. I press the button. You have 10 seconds.
So then I start hearing a countdown, it sounds computerized, and I'm like, that's probably the bomb. And I was like, dude, my mom's gonna be so disappointed that I didn't finish the spelling bee. So I knew I had to finish strong, and I got back up. They gave me the word because, but I forgot the U. And my mom started booing me off stage.
So we're tied at this point. Jimmy got one wrong, I got one wrong, and then I started hearing this woman in the crowd. She goes, boo, boo, you suck. And I'm thinking, is that my mom? Did she actually come for once? You know, it'd be the first time she showed up for anything in my life. So I felt like I related to Jimmy, and I was like, this rivalry has gone on for too long. And so I take off the bomb, but it's the only thing I was wearing. So, you know. I'm just kind of angry, man.
So then my classmate starts stripping down on the spelling bee stage. And I'm like, dude! This is a public area. What are you doing? And he's like, dude, I changed my mind about blowing you up. And I was like, dude. And then my confidence skyrocketed even higher.
You know, this time around when I saw Jimmy happy, I started getting this, like, tingly feeling in my chest. And I thought, at first, like, is this what it means to be happy because somebody else is happy? But then, you know, later on, I kind of realized it was bomb residue, which is really terrible for when you're going through TSA, which I had to go through. I should have thought that one through.
All right, thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Now, I know we have a lot of foreign film buffs in the audience. What might be the name of a non-English-speaking movie from Europe that has not been done before?
Gustavo.
Gustavo, is that what I heard?
Yes.
Gustavo. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to see a scene from Gustavo. Let's bring up the microphone, folks. And Sarah, are you one of the mics? Yeah, I think you are. I think Sarah, you are.
Okay.
That's Max and Sarah. Okay, great. And Joaquin and Pun will be the actors. And what's going to happen is we're going to see a scene from Gustavo, of course, being a foreign film. When they speak, it's being dubbed for them. So we're going to see this scene from Gustavo. Let's bring the lights down and let's see what happens.
So I walk up to him and I say, hey, partner, why don't you go take 2 steps forward and 2 steps back?
And so I take 2 steps forward and 2 steps back because I'm a very compliant little guy. And then I shimmy around. Shimmy, shimmy, shimmy.
I say, hey, that's not okay, partner. Look at my gumball.
Hey, what the hell? That's the biggest gumball I've ever seen in my whole life. How many years have you been working on that?
I say, I've been working on that for my entire life.
Your entire life? Goddamn!
So I hold it up and I look at it. And oh my god, it was big.
It was really big, so I took it and I put it in my mouth.
No, no way, no, no, what? What? You cannot do that. So I looked him in the eyes and I said, I got a gun, and you got my gum.
I said, Bobby, here you go, you can have it back.
And that was room too fine, so I put it back in my pocket where it belonged.
Okay, yeah, you do you, bud. You do you. That's a little gross, but okay.
With a smile on my face, I took 2 steps forward and 2 steps back.
And I shimmy, shimmy, shimmy. Shimmy, 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 shimmy.
Oh.
Daddy.
Jif Jajinda's junk jet joshed, Jujar Jetting drowned
it. Drowned it!
Yes, Jujar Jetting drowned it! Juju Jungus Nanji!
Jajinda's
junk joshed, Jai Junk G Jable Jujuk Jow Jow. Runny, Miss Winrose. Bitch Reezy. She's Jai Jujo.
Zombie! That's already the set of Jojo! We'll do it!
Risen me a wrong rainy! You rob those ring rows! You rob them root!
If you roll on, if Zoo, so like Zoo, how Zoo do it, then they'll do it!
Cheer, cheer, chow about gist. Jif Ju Josh Jajindos Jal Jake Ju 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 Juvie Jeter Ju Josh Ju Josh Jatman?
Jatman?
Jeff!
Zoma Zod!
Ju Jaff Ju Josh Jajindos.
Is that it? So do it.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. Let's bring out Max and Pappy. And what we'd like from you is a letter of the alphabet to start with.
C.
C, I heard. Okay. The first sentence that one of them says will start with the letter C. The next sentence will start with the letter D, and so on. Now, this is a, what would be something that would make a good impression on a new friend?
Corvette.
A Corvette. One of you has a Corvette, so you're trying to impress the other one. And that can come out in a different way. This letter starts, this scene starts with the letter C, then the next one goes to D, etc. When it gets back and finishes with B, the scene will be over. So, trying to make an impression on a new friend with a Corvette. Let's bring the lights down.
Clarence, Clancy, Limbo, my friend. Have you seen my new Corvette?
Darn right I have, and it is fantastic.
Egad, they all said, and they looked at me like, why would you spend your money on a Corvette? You're living on the streets. As well, I said, you don't have a Corvette.
For real.
Go get one. All I gotta say.
How might I get a Corvette? They don't sell them around here. You have to go 400 miles to the nearest Corvette shop.
It's really quite simple. You buy a Corvette, drive the distance, buy a Corvette, drive the distance backward, and you end with a Corvette.
Ah, oh, okay. Okay. Just like that, huh? Okay. I guess this is sort of a chicken and egg scenario. Why don't I will myself to have a Corvette? Will that work?
Kelp is better than gasoline. For fueling Corvettes.
Let me see. There are multiple options for fueling a Corvette car. Kelp, coal, gas. And
mice is not one of them, I have tried.
Now, I did know a man who had a Corvette that ran on mice.
Oh, that is not possible.
Perhaps it was a figment of my imagination.
Queer letters.
Right. So, you have a Corvette,
super.
And I find that very impressive. Want to take me for a spin?
Super! Awesome! Yes!
To the Corvette we go.
Us. Corvette. Right now.
Very good.
Well
welcome to my Corvette.
Spacious, isn't it?
Ximena is a good name for Corvette. I see you've named it. It says right here, Ximena. What a nice dashboard this is, man.
You better ignore the Honda Civic logo. I think that was a mistake on their part.
Zounds. This is really nice.
Hey, thanks, buddy.
Better drive to CVS. I have to get my new prescription medication.
A good action adventure movie. Everybody? Yeah. Yay! Okay, well, you're in luck because we've got a scene from a fantastic action adventure for you tonight. We need Max and Ash. Now, Max and Ash are famous actors and they've made tons of money. They have to be really careful with their body because of all the work they've had done, and they just have to be careful. So every time they do a stunt in their action-adventure movie, they have to call in stunt doubles to do it. So I need a title of an action-adventure that has never been done before.
The Power Outage.
The Power Outage. Okay. All right. So let's bring the lights down and bring them back up for the Power Outage.
Hey, man. My wife's stepbrother's uncle's little sister's terribly sick. And the power went out at the hospital.
Oh no! We must give her zucchohydrine. Pronto!
We must get to the hospital, but it is a tough journey to get there.
How will we do it?
Well, we don't have a car, so we better use our feet.
To walk?
To walk.
But there's a big hole in front of us. How we cross?
I think it is a sinkhole.
I see little ants in there, very angry.
Oh no, it is not a sinkhole, it is a giant anthill with giant ants!
We better jump into it.
And fight the ants!
Stunt double!
Oh man, I never expected ants to taste so good, but they made me a bit loopy.
They are not sitting well inside of me.
Oh, I can feel them crawling everywhere.
That part is okay, but there are too many of them.
It kind of feels like butterflies in my stomach.
How are we supposed to exit this big hole?
Well, we don't have a ladder.
We don't have a car.
We must climb!
We must climb, but I see no holes to put our fingers.
Well, we must dig some holes so that we will have a foothold.
But where will we find a shovel? Perhaps in that homeless man's mouth.
Of course!
Stunt double!
I'm sorry, I don't like hurting people!
I think she will be how you say a-okay.
I think, hopefully, you are right. Maybe we should bring him along to the hospital.
That is a challenge, considering he is everywhere at the same time.
We're going to need to pick up the parts.
You are correct. Maybe we can use him to build a ladder.
Of course! Stunt double!
I can make it to the hospital for my wife's uncle's stepbrother's little sister.
Come and climb quick, it may fall over.
Oh, it's very squishy.
Oh. I am on top.
I am also on top.
Now, I have a very good idea instead of us falling in sinkhole.
What
we
is
will
your idea?
Take the train.
Of course! Let us board the train.
There is one problem.
Yes?
The train is inside of that sinkhole.
Looks like we are going for a dive.
Looks like we will do that, yes. However, it is full. There are no more seats.
We are going to have to make more.
We are going to have to take people out of the train by force.
That is what I was implying!
Of course!
Probably need to see a therapist now and then, so we're going to have a counseling scene right now. What is something you may need to go to the therapist for as far as couples counseling? What's that? Interest in your sibling? Okay. You're attracted to a sibling. Okay, fair enough. We'll find out about that. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to bring the players out here. So let's bring the lights down and bring the players out. Please bring the lights down. Interest, go ahead, bring the lights down, and we'll see what happens. Bring them back up.
Okay, so what brings you two in today?
Little Jimmy's obsessed with his brother.
No, you're not in the scene, Bill.
I'm sorry. Can somebody please start talking?
His sister's hot.
Okay. How do you feel about that?
Yeah, my sister's up.
Are you two together?
Yeah.
I guess.
And how long have you been together?
Since we were born. We're kind of twins.
I meant together romantically.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So twins, you mean like biological twins, or like we just grew up together next door to one another and our parents are friends?
I don't think you'd like my answer.
Yeah, maybe let's leave it. Okay, so your sister is hot, right? And you both agree
really
on this?
Hot.
Yeah.
And so what's the conflict? Because I mean, despite how I may or may not feel about those feelings, I don't see how that's creating an argument.
Well, he wants our sister. And I want our sister, and...
Okay, can we just call her your sister, please, for my own sake? Regardless of how related she is to both of you. Let's stick with mine instead of ours.
All right, Doc.
Okay, so... I'm sorry, I've never had this situation before. A pretty new therapist.
I mean, this is Alabama.
Yeah, I really don't... I just... cheapest state in the country. So, okay, anyways, how can we work through this conflict of both of you wanting somebody else, not important who she is? That really isn't what I was thinking.
Battle
we don't
to,
we don't do battles in this office. Everybody take three deep breaths. Just calm it down a little. Calm it down. Let me remind you that you are either related or in love with each other.
But both. It's both.
Okay, well, think about how much you care for one another. You don't want to hurt each other. I really, truly believe that.
I just want to hurt him.
Okay, Let's pretend that she doesn't exist for a minute, okay?
What?
She doesn't exist. No, it's she's never existed, so there's nothing amiss.
She's all I think about.
She's in my...
If she had never existed and currently did not exist, what would you guys say to each other about your relationship, regardless of this other person?
I love you, bro.
Hey, I feel like we're getting somewhere. Yeah.
I've known you since the day I was conceived.
Okay.
Yeah.
And do you still both want to be with one another? Of course.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's my brother, my soulmate, my twin.
I get the sense that maybe you guys want to give each other a hug. Yeah.
And curtain. All right, ladies and gentlemen. Go ahead, Mindy, sit them down there.
Okay, yes, so, for this next game, we got some seniors coming out, Sarah, Katon, and Andre. Sorry. A reason to be upset with your physics teacher. What is a reason to be upset with your physics teacher?
Stephen Hawking.
Okay? All right. So what they're going to do is all the suggestions that you made earlier are right here. And so they're going to get to a point in the story where they're going to be able to come over here and pick one of these up and incorporate whatever is on that paper into their story. So, let's take the lights down and bring it back up. A group of students mad at their physics teacher because of Stephen Hawking.
I can't stand it anymore.
I can't. You know what? You know what, Teach? Us both, all of your students, are tired of you talking about how you met Stephen Hawking. We're tired of it.
If you met the man, you would know. You would know exactly how I feel.
Okay, sure, we didn't. I'm sure he was a really great guy, one of the best guys, super smart, all that, got you into the career of physics. But you don't stop talking about him. This is more of a Stephen Hawking class than a physics class now.
And what's wrong with that?
It's been 2 weeks, and I have heard your Stephen Hawking story 27 times.
So what?
You know what? That just really makes me want to say that it's tick season in here.
A division among the ranks here. I actually think that
it's better late than never. Alright?
You need to stop it now. Alright? You can't undo what you've done.
Yeah.
Listen, I think you need to hear something.
Okay.
Okay.
What?
Okay.
You need to hear something that's real.
Yeah?
Okay.
What is it?
I met him.
Oh my god!
And he was in his wheelchair.
Give me a man after midnight. Because I cannot stand this Stephen Hawking.
You know who couldn't stand either? You know who couldn't stand?
Oh, let me guess, Stephen Hawking!
About horses or something. Or
yeah,
I can tell you
gravity.
This. Helicopter! Helicopter!
Finally, we're getting somewhere! How does that work? Tell me, please!
Wait, how does the air move across the helicopter wings?
The air, the aerodynamics of the helicopter wing.
Yeah. Come on, give me something, anything.
Look, I met Stephen
Hawking. Oh my god!
No!
That's what she said!
Your previous physics teacher.
We don't need to have two physics teachers that met Stephen Hawking. Both of them.
I think that should be the only requirement.
You make my heart suffer. You know what?
You know how that makes me feel?
It makes me feel like I'm in Diana's math class.
That's cool.
Yeah. Well, you know how it makes me feel? Happy, happy home!
Well, that's great. So you want to hear it again? I was on the corner.
You can't tell sarcasm when you hear it, Teach.
He was in his wheelchair, and look at this. You would not believe it. His finger moves! That's how he talks! Listen. I'm still talking.
Oh god, you gotta stop! You gotta stop! Be better!
Please, tell me about elastic potential energy. Please,
elastic
difference.
Forces!
Energy.
Velocities! Anything!
Forces.
That's some forces other than Steven, right?
Overflow is
yes,
I'm writing that down in my notebook.
Yes, where is my notebook?
Overflow is sixth force in the universe. And this is when something cannot take any more and it explodes.
That's just like last night when I was almost attacked by Bigfoot!
Oh my god!
And Curtin! Thank you, ladies and gentlemen! Okay, we're going to have our last bit coming up here in a moment. But before we do, I want to thank Up on Lights, Bill and Mason. Let's hear it for them. And one more time of appreciation for Mari Claire. Before we go, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to do an ensemble Valentine's poem for you, but what we'd like is some sort of a scary title. What might that title be?
My Ex.
The Dark. My Ex, I heard. Okay, great. This is a story called My Ex, and we'll sing Let's Bring the Players Out. This is a Valentine's poem, and there we go. Okay. So I can see everybody. Ladies and gentlemen, my ex.
My ex smells like stinky gym socks.
My ex has hair longer than Rapunzel and has never brushed it once.
My ex could reach me in places I can't even reach myself. My ex smells like dirty socks.
My ex was really fun when I first met them, but now we write letters to each other about how much we hate each other.
My ex tried to kill me not once, not twice, but three separate times.
My ex was a master manipulator.
My ex, I really don't miss them.
If you met my ex, you wouldn't like them, and they'd probably try to kill you out of jealousy, I hope.
Your words were always so charming, but your actions ever harming. I believe it was quite alarming that I even considered you.
My ex and I were once in love, but then we started sending vicious texts.
Oh, my ex is so hateful. I am but a man. She looks like an unopened can of Spam.
As aforementioned, my ex smells like socks, but boy does she make me hard as rocks.
My ex, I don't know the problem, but wherever he goes, he can't stop showing off his pecs.
My ex really likes to flex.
And if you dated him, he'd be your ex too.
And Kurt!